Okay, now now what will happen? Suppose you define the position of the string and you go to the string also. Okay, so it will convert into Unicode. Okay, then it will pass to the phone layer, or we can say it's going to inside the phone. Okay, so inside the phone we have various codes. Okay, so each and every Unicode value is going to be, suppose I am referring to this example is for English. And by the way, English and the letter.
Converted
12 number. That number again is in memory, you can use it. Ratio 12. Then one more combination coming, that is na kalam gya. How do we combine gya? Right? That has been number 7, 8, and 9. Okay? 7 and 9, 7 is na, 8 is 7, 9 is gya. I'm talking about the second table. It's clear, right? Then if you create the table, that is 16. That will be na, nya. Na, account, na, and nya. Okay? Then the same table is going to be verified into with conversion. That will be 12 will be child. You go to child level. And 6 is the, by default is there already. And 16 is. This is what happened in Intel languages. This is the basically you can say that complexity of Intel language, or we can say powerfulness of Intel language. So both ways it is, we can say. Okay. So, now I am coming to Android product. What are the challenges are there in Android? Again, before that I want to say, Android 4.1 high Intel language support on the core OS level itself. Supports almost 6 languages now. But again, why this is important? Because if you want to do something in Android 2.0 or 2.2 or 3, it will be really difficult. Okay. So let's look into the Android in the current scenario. This is reference to 2.3 source code, AOSP source code. Okay. Basically, Android supports our OpenType function. I mean, it supports the ingredient from the OpenType function, what is there, but only thing the rendering part is missing. You can say reordering and everything is missing. I will tell you what exactly mean the reordering later. Reordering what and everything is missing. Okay. So, and in 2.3 source code, AOSP source code, we have identified that its rendering part is handled by java.txt. java.txt class. So they are not using Kia, they are not using any rendering engine or rendering algorithm for rendering text. They are using java.txt, and java.txt can handle only Latin text. I mean, English. You can say 1-to-1 Latin. Take a display A in the screen, take B display A in the screen. Okay. They have to put an algorithm for rendering any complex script inside the AOSP source. Only in the AOSP source code. But interesting, but same time, there are a lot of mobiles are there in the market which are running, it supports all Intel languages. When I have a mobile which is running on Android 2.3, it supports all Intel languages. I don't know how it's happening, the source code is not available properly. That's a sad part. I don't come to that part. Okay, so what exactly happening in the, so JavaScript is handling the, pushing the containers from the, defining the position and painting the text from the screen. And taking the connection from the model Java. Okay. So now, what we are proposing, as we are discussing before starting the session, initially I was supposed to enable all the stuff in the core OS level. I was trying to enable everything in the core OS level and create OS with all the support, then push it for public. Then I start in the OS way. It won't be a practical thing. So if you are having a mobile phone, if you want to create an application in the language, it won't be possible to build put a new OS or new OS image in your mobile. It's not practical at all. Suppose you are running Android 2.3, doesn't have Intel language support, and you are running Intel language application there. It's impossible because if you enable an OS, you have to rebuild the OS, you have to compile the OS again into mobile phone and put it in the mobile phone. I mean, can we can say hydrogen or something, you have to. That's impossible. And also, the same time Android release 4.1 with Intel language support. So then start with the OS part. Okay, now you have to depend on the OS part. I can be only looking to the application layer. Application layer. Means, anyone can create an application with Intel language that can be platform independent, either depending on Android 2.3, 2.2, or 4.0, or any mobile system, Samsung, Galaxy, whatever the mobile phone you can stand. That's what I'm trying to create. So it will be completely platform independent. The user or application developer, you don't need to worry about what OS is running there. It can be from everywhere. So this is our approach, and let's see how to perform. So this is the basic flow of the processor, what exactly I mean. So we are having two layers again. One is application layer, which is taking care of the rendering and everything. One is phone layer, which we did some customization the OTF. So what we are doing there, initially for testing purpose, we are creating a proper library layer, you know. We are testing purpose, what we are doing there, we are converting the text into our way of encoding. I'm converting the Unicode text into our way of encoding methods. Okay? That will be the input into text. Okay. Then what I'm doing is that everyone may know about SCADA. By using Asset Manager, I'll be defining the font inside the application. Okay. By using typeface plus typeface plus, I'm defining the font which font I will use and where the font will get. Where you get the font. Okay. So these are the basic flow what you are looking for. Now we get the text view display the text view properly without any issues. So in this layer we haven't did anything in the Android. I mean Android we are doing the standard which is already there. I mean asset manager is already there and type manager is also there. Okay. But we need a lot of programming and a lot of different definition developing in the rendering part. Because there's a lot of challenges are there facing for creating the language rendering properly in the Android. So let's discuss that. So we have two layers again, font layer and application layer, as I mentioned earlier. So we have did some changes in the font. So as I mentioned earlier, the issues with reordering the text and rendering the text. Not like, you know, there's no issue to identify the font and get the font from the font file. That is perfectly handled by Android. Okay. So what we did there, whatever the combination layers are coming, I mean, suppose so, as I mentioned, the file and will become kra. This have to be handled by font plus the rendering engine. But the rendering engine is not there to take care of these things in Android. So what we did there, we created a separate view sets inside the OpenType font. Inside the standard OpenType font, we created a separate view sets for all these details. Like we created a separate grid for kra and we defined the value ASCII values for that as a two-type font. So we can say this is a combination of OpenType font plus two-type font. OpenType font parameters are there with unique values plus we create one set of glyphs with ASCII values, or you can use the open space like open unicode values also. And if we combine both together and create an algorithm for combining it properly and displaying the screen. So that is the picture I'm mentioning here. What are the modifications we have made in the font level first of all. Okay. So first see the first point, ka is combination of ka, halan, ka. So by theoretically or by the standard of OpenType, again OpenType is standard by Microsoft. OpenType Microsoft, what I'll use in Microsoft is saying that this ought to be formed by ka, halan, ka, how to form ka everywhere. That's another the dependent. What we did there, Android doesn't have this algorithm for doing this thing, so we create a separate clip for that inside the font itself by defining by using a ASCII web parameter. Okay, so we have decided to call and call like this. We depend all the combinations, call and call and call, sub, everything depends inside the font itself. Okay, second part of this is what to form basically ma, column, ra, become mra. That also has to define inside the font itself. Okay. Like this we have almost all the parameters inside the font itself. Whatever the combination, whatever it is rendering properly, and which is looking for all the feature part, like towards for all other languages also, we depend everything inside the font. This is the previous slide regarding about the font. This is regarding the libraries. Some of the examples, what are the challenges we are facing in the library part. It's one of the examples, com means Bulgarian, most of what is meaning com. So here is the combination of ka, a mantra and ma. Okay. So when typing this to the, it should show that a mantra would join with ka. Otherwise it will like ka, then some space will come, then ma will come. So that issue is there, so we made algorithm for that inside the rendering engine for solving that. Okay. So this is the character. If I is calm, the character is calm and now if we are now using OpenType font or if we are not using Android, we can write a car face that arm of the way comes to become. One more charity body is swim. This is kind of the key of the symbol. Suppose if you are trying to print how it's formulated, you can the last point without OpenType font. Normally if it's not happening properly, it will come behind the ma. Ma letter. how it's out of bounds? The electron will be come behind the tall electron by theoretically. I mean, theoretically, the symbol E matra of the symbol appears after the So what is the second element of the thing is that key matra output come whenever a key matra is used with any consonant, it will come behind the consonant. That is the common standard for doing. But if we don't have an algorithm for doing that, or we have an intelligence for doing that, it will automatically come up, it come behind the mean error. So this also already algorithmically sorted out. I just gave some basic external data, other things also be done. So this is some. Now this is example. It's an Android example. This is the additional main Java file or Java file where I am defining the text view as typeface with the typeface values and also getting the phone from the asset manager asset folder. So I have defined the phone there, Gujarat phone server defined. You can see hindi.ebi and also I defend the typeface for both Hindi and Gujarati with the text field under in the screen. So this is the XML file how I defined there. And look at the contents of the text there. This is the earlier case the Unicode text which I converted into our method of encoding it. So in between something like this, Marvel, you can see the Marvel, Hindi word. Second last one. Marvel, there is a U symbol, see ASCII value, which has been taken from the quantum. So what I said, I did that, I have converted the text into our method way of encoding and put it there in this case. This is only for testing purpose. What we are trying to say, do that, we are creating a separate render mechanism for converting the text once we convert text automatically in the backend. It will automatically put the push the connection to the screen. Okay. So this is the plan, and this is the daily initial stage, and we are going to release the source code for public within a week or two. We are just putting this to the, and later on we have to defend how exactly how we integrate this thing to the Android as a library, not in the core source code. We are talking about application languages. We are handing out the options for that how to integrate this thing. And also we can add other languages very easily because you have defined a phone and also how to create the algorithm. Once the common base is ready, then we can add any other languages very easily. Yeah, that's only plan. And basically this rendering engines, we are taking some inputs from two projects, this is the CEDAC Mumbai. I am also part of the project where I am there in CEDAC. One is Tezu project, another is project Mix. Both are rendering engines for enabling Indian language support for Linux, which has been introduced in 2002 or 2003 or something, too long back. Yeah, that's all. Yeah. I have a demo, but I don't know how to show it. Anyone can want to show the thing, I can show it in more than after the session.
Yeah. So, write this library actors.
Oh yeah, so
ask me. So you started the point which actually now giving
the challenging part is like again is Arthus how to enable in the core system level, OS level.
No, you could have used the same thing and package it as part of your application.
No, it is not possible because for rendering anything system it will be part of the OS level system. I don't think so. Because IS code asks us, and I am touching with the person with the developer. And also we can do ICVs, we can do ICV also the same way. Or Pango also there, we can do Pango also the same way. And I assume so they are using Pango, sorry, ICU in 4.1. I'm not sure, ICU 4.4 rendering the text. Even Java itself, I mean, it's from rendering process for Indian languages. But they are not using that.
Where
Java
is in
4.1. I'm not sure. But again, what I'm trying to say that again, Arthus ought to be enabled in the core system level. It is. Okay. Yeah.
So, what kind of license?
That has been decided, but I think it will be quite straightforward. GPL. I guess in the city, I think it's a license or whatever. But everything will be available for public. Enter code, enter ID, and everything will be available for public. Things stored is a thing. I mean, network area. I want to know. Apache is a production like what Google is doing. Because I haven't told anything about licensing, but I'm sure it will be open source for public. Whatever license you want, you can try to use license. We will be creating one set of forms for each and every one. Only one set of forms. So currently in this term we are using Garvey font, you know about Garvey font. Which has been developed by us only. Us means CDAC, while I have CDAC developer. So we added all the parameters in the Garvey font system. And for Gujarati we use Padma font. Padma font, you heard of Padma font? We use Padma font for Gujarati. So we are planning, we will take the name of GPL license font and we will add all that. And you can release that font. One like, font will be available for one language.
So
no, the extension will be same TTF only. But the, I mean, all the TrueType font and OpenType font have the same extension TTF only. But the behavior will be different. Font will, concept will be same. I mean, TTF extension will be same. Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
The downside of this is, we have two data, right? The proper reading code and the convert rate code, we have no question. So, if our application is data-driven, that means the size of data is